Can you imagine if I forgot to turn the microphone on? Again? Hey, what's going on, guys? Welcome back to the channel. I hope that you're having a lovely day. My name is Justin, and thank you so much for being here in the first place. Today, we are listening to the Mahavishnu Orchestra with the first track off of their album, The Inner Mountain Flame, Meeting of the Spirits, which was released in 1971. So the Mahavishnu, I have had them on my list to come back to. We've listened to a few tracks from them, and I've always wanted to circle back around. So today we will be meeting the spirits, or at least in this case, Mahavishnu Orchestra. Hey, let's have a fun little thing. Let's go to my jazz playlist and let's recommend you a song from there. I've done that a few times, but it's always nice to, you know, show you guys a peek of what I'm listening to. I admit that I haven't added anything of recent in my jazz playlist, and where is it? Okay, it's all the way here at the bottom. All right, so we will go to my jazz playlist, I will press shuffle, and whatever song pops up is my recommendation. If it's like a really common one, like Take Five, I'm probably just gonna skip, okay? So here we go, let's see. It is First Hymnopede by Eddie Daniels. Hymnopedi, Gymnoped, Gymnopedi, Gymnopedi. It's just a jazz version of a classic. This is good though. This is just chill. I know it's not strictly jazz, but it's on my jazz playlist. Hey, let's give you another one. Why not? Let's give another one. Classical Jazz Quartet. Movement 1, Part 4. I am a sucker for a classical jazz fusion. I like that. Anyways, those are my recommendations. I have to turn on my mouse, but for right now, let's listen to the Mahavishnu Orchestra with Meeting of the Spirits. Let's go. We'll be right back. Wow. That was more than a meeting of the spirits. That felt like a soul eruption. All right, can you imagine seeing that live? Can you imagine being in that crowd watching this performance live? That would be stunning. I feel like you would be dumbfounded, amazed, and just blown away. You know? That's a really good track. That's a really good track. And everyone stood out so much. I mean, of course, John, I think I've mispronounced his last name previously. I think it's John McLaughlin, not John McLaughlin. But John on the guitar, man, he makes that thing beg. He makes that thing scream out. Love his aggressive, very sharp tone. It doesn't let up. Very few times in this track does it let up and kind of waver in the ambience of the space. But this is a high octane ride from 0 to 100 in just a few minutes, 6 minutes or so. Billy Cobham on the drums. We've listened to a little bit, very little bit, of his first track off of his album Spectrum. And man, he is drumming brilliantly here. Once again, the whole band. Actually, I know I say this sometimes, like, they played like they were on fire. But here, like, can you, like, hear it? Especially in their energy. And Cobham is just banging away. He doesn't care. He has no scruples. He has no restraint. And why bother? He is playing like a man possessed in this one. I also really like the addition, of course, Jerry Goodman on the violin, but Jan Hammer, who we've listened to recently on the keyboards and the organ. I like the little solo you get later on with the organ. I like the addition of the organ. I think the organ is just one of those instruments that makes a lot of things better. But the harmonization between the violin and the guitar later on, it almost felt like they were double tracking each other. And then they break off, and Jerry gets a solo of his own, in which is interspersed with some organ. And that just sounds really nice. I like the space that's left for them to play because John takes up a lot of it. And I mean that in a good way. Like, it's good. It's good what he does with it because this one has a lot of depth to it. And I don't think it's overly busy. It is a busy song, no doubt. It's not a pedestrian song. It's not a song that you would, see someone listening to on a sidewalk. This is a driving high-speed racetrack on this one. But at the same time, there are a few moments of a little bit more openness, a little bit more space, and the band properly builds back out of that space into the proper groove that they've established listening to this track. This was good. This was a good one. Listen to they open this up like a dark church, right? Those organ riffs, service, but what kind? And then the way that Cobham just breaks this groove, getting into it. I love the depth of his kick, by the way. Just as a production side note, I love how, like, you can feel it in your chest. And the soft fade-in of the drums and the rest of the instruments here. Hear the kicks? That quiet thump, like someone creeping to your door before the orchestra opens that door. This is the essence of jazz fusion because you can listen to the jazz part of it. You can absolutely hear that, but at the same time, you're rocking out. Like, I feel like, for example, my dad, jazz purist, okay? I mean, purist. He does not really go outside of the jazz circle and realm. I feel like he'll probably even like this a little bit. Like, honestly, I think he would. And then you got the violin coming in with Goodman, the organ at the same time. See how it adds like kind of a stop for a second. That's kind of a twisted edge to it, right? Like, it was kind of grooving and jazzy, maybe a little mysterious, but when the violin and the organ, they start creeping in, there's a different kind of vibe. Huh? Very reminiscent of the title of the song. And this explosion. They just keep it going. This is perpetual motion. And there he is, John. And I would say that there's something very tribal and very earthy about, yeah, the music as a whole, but I would actually say specifically out of John's tone. It feels very natural and yet unnatural at the same time. It feels raw. It feels like there's no, I mean, I'm sure there's effects on it or whatever, But it doesn't feel like it. It feels like we are just hearing the strings crying out from the guitar. Halfway through, and listen to that tone, still so raw. He doesn't make it softer yet. That is so interesting. He keeps that same raw tone, even in that moment, which is noticeably calmed down. But halfway through the track at that point, they give you a break. They give you a little intermission. Go get your popcorn, go get your coffee, go get whatever you need. Because we're coming back. this is just a brief little rest. And then we're coming back hard. And the keys here are noticeably jazzy. So jazzy. Listen to just that splash that Cobham's playing adds a bigger, like, more momentous kind of sound and rhythm to the whole thing. Almost like an urgency, a distress call in a way. I don't know. Regardless of all that, this is a fantastic track. Love to hear all these musicians doing what they do best, and that's just creating great music. Actually, I do have something that I didn't notice in the beginning, and I just read it right now. This is their debut album. This is the first track off of their debut album. If that doesn't get you in, I don't know what will. If that doesn't convince you, you went to the record store that day. You said, "Huh, this looks kind of interesting. The Maha what? Orchestra? Okay. John McLaughlin. Okay. That's kind of cool. Very simple, album cover. Okay. I see that they're the Heart of the Flame. Okay. You take it home. You put this on. You say, okay, let's see what these guys are up to, you know? And you're blasted away with this. You understand why they are the heart of that fire. That's awesome. Let me know, however, what you guys thought. Join me on Twitter in the comments down below. Hope that you enjoyed the music. Hopefully you enjoyed. Myself. If you did, you can definitely leave a like. If you didn't like it, you can dislike, but, you know, I'd rather you just don't click anything. Just go. You can leave your comments, of course, down below. And I just hope that you had a good time. Hopefully I will see you tomorrow. And regardless of all of that, have a wonderful morning, afternoon, evening, whatever it may be. Whatever time this video may have chanced upon you. Hope it's a great one for the rest of the day. And I will talk to you tomorrow. Bye.